वन इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कंट्रोल वाल्स. दोज आर डायरेक्शन कंट्रोल वाल्स, फ्लो कंट्रोल वाल्स, ओके, पपेट वाल्स एंड स्पूल वाल्स, नॉन रिटन वाल्स, एवरीथिंग. एंड टुडे आल्सो विल सी सम मोर वाल्स यूज्ड इन फ्लूइड सिस्टम्स. ओके, now we are in actuating systems. And we are learning about fluid systems which are used for actuation in mechatronic system. Okay, we are discussing about the components used in fluid systems. We have already seen so many components like pumps, compressors, filters, valves. Okay, in today's class also we will cover some more valves or some more components. Okay, next we are in control valves. I have already explained about direction control valves, okay, flow control valves. Okay, today we will see some more valves. Okay, let me explain about the quick exhaust valve. Our first topic in today's class is quick exhaust valve. Only 75 members only. I will see one more minute. Okay, first topic. Okay, let me explain about quick exhaust valve. The name itself explains it is a quick exhaust, means sometimes it needs the rapid movement of the piston, means the fast movement of piston is needed, then we need to remove the air in fast manner, means quickly we have to remove the air from the cylinder. Okay, suppose if you want to remove the air through direction control valve, but it offers some resistance, so it takes some time, so we need a shortcut to remove the air from the cylinder for quick movement of the piston. Okay, that shortcut way to remove the air from the cylinder in fast manner, that is nothing but quick exhaust valve. The main purpose of the quick exhaust valve is to remove the air from the cylinder in fastest manner. It is a shortcut way to remove the air from the cylinder that will cause the fast rapid movement of the piston, sometimes needed. So the valve is used for shortcut way to remove the air from the cylinder, from the actuator. Okay, this is the construction of the exhaust valve. See this. This is the shortcut way. Okay, initially the valve is open position. Okay, the pressure port is connected to the outlet port. If suppose I want to remove the air in a quick manner, I am opening this quick exhaust valve like this. Then the air is moving to the atmosphere immediately in a quick manner. So this is the opening and closing of the exhaust valve, and this is the symbol for the exhaust valve. Okay, generally the exhaust valve is mounted at the nearest to the actuator. Okay, this is the quick exhaust valve. This is the direction valve. The quick exhaust valve is at the nearest to the actuator. So actually the actuator is moving or operating with the help of direction control valve. If you need to move the piston immediately, we are removing the air through quick exhaust valve. This is the symbol for the quick exhaust valve. Okay, now we see this video. initially, see this. Initially, the air is moving in this way to the cylinder, okay, through direction control valve. Suppose I want to remove the air in a quick manner, but if you want to remove the air through direction control valve, it takes time. So we need a shortcut way, that is the quick exhaust valve. This is the shortcut way. If you remove this plug, okay, the air is moving towards atmosphere in a quick manner. See this. This is the quick exhaust valve. Suppose if you want to remove the air immediately, just open this. Okay, that causes the air moving towards atmosphere immediately. It bursts towards atmosphere. Okay, this is the quick exhaust valve. Okay, the main purpose of the quick exhaust valve is to remove the air from the cylinder in a shortcut way. Next one is sequence valve. Second, next one is sequence valve. Suppose suppose we are performing two operations, okay, one after another, means the operations are in sequence. So if you want to perform the operation sequence of operations for controlling that operations, we are using sequence control valves. Okay, I will explain with a video. Suppose see this video. We have two operations. When two operations are performed in sequence, we are using sequence valve. Suppose the operations are, see this. This is a sheet metal. First operation, we need to hold this sheet. We need to hold this sheet with the help of one actuator. And second operation is to bend the sheet with another actuator. So here we have two operations, holding and bending. See this, holding. The first operation, second operation is bending. So first operation is holding, second operation is bending. After holding only, we are bend the sheet. So these two operations follow a particular sequence. Okay, for the operation, for performing these two operations in sequence, we are using sequence valves. See this. Holding, bending. Now we see the operation, these two operations, how these two operations are performed by using a sequence valve. See this. Here two actuators are there. Okay, this actuator is for holding, means clamping. This actuator is used for bending the sheet. First, the pump, okay, pumps the fluid to the hydraulic circuit. This is the sequence valve. Okay, now we see the operation. First operation, clamping. So first, the direction valve sends the fluid towards clamping cylinder. Okay, means the fluid is moving from the pump towards clamping cylinder. Now the clamping cylinder is the piston is moving, okay, and clamps the and holds the sheet. Now the cylinder of the clamping cylinder is filled, so there is no way for the fluid. Already the cylinder is filled, so the pressure inside the valve is increases. Here we are setting a piston, okay, see this. Okay, here the piston is set at preset value. Okay, means If the piston is moving at certain pressure only, okay, while the fluid is moving towards clamping cylinder, already clamping cylinder is filled, still the pump is pumping the fluid, means the inside of the valve, the pressure is increases. Because of increasing pressure, okay, at particular stage, that pressure moves this piston towards out, means this moves this piston against this spring. So that causes opening of this port. Then the fluid is moving towards this cylinder. Again, once again, I will explain. First, the pump, okay, pumping the fluid through direction control valve. The direction control valve sends the fluid towards clamping actuator. Means the fluid is moving in this cylinder, clamping cylinder. Okay, then the piston moves upwards and that clamps the workpiece. Now the cylinder is filled, means there is no way to fluid. Okay, now again the fluid is continuously filling this chamber, means continuous filling causes increase of pressure. At certain pressure, okay, the piston moves against this spring. Already the piston is set at preset value. That preset value reaches the pressure causes the movement of this piston. Okay, that opens the port. Here we have a port B. Okay, then second operation starts. Okay, there is a gap between the time gap between these two cylinders. According to that time gap, we are setting the preset pressure. When the preset pressure obtained, then only it second port opens. Now see this. See this? Here the cylinder. Continuously the pressure increases. When pressure is more than the preset value, it moves against the spring and port B is opened. Now the bending cylinder operates. Bending operation is done. Again, we are changing the direction control valve position, and that removes the oil from this valve. See this. We are changing the position, we are removing the fluid. Once again, see the operation. First, we are sending the fluid to cylinder one. Cylinder one moves and pressure increases. At certain pressure, pushes this piston towards again a spring, the cylinder. Okay, if pressure is more than that, it moves up, that causes opening of port B. That operates second cylinder, means it performs second operation. So the first operation already done, second operation sequentially at particular time interval, second operation also done. Okay, the setting of pressure, pre-setting of pressure is done with the help of spring, that is depending on the time between the holding and bending. This is called sequence valve. By using sequence valve, we can perform the two operations in sequence. Okay, that is the thing. Next valve is time delay valve. Time delay valve. See the construction of time delay valve. Here we have three ports: pressure port, outlet port, and return port. And we have a spool here, the pilot spool. Okay, the closing and opening of port is done this with the help of this spool, this slider. Okay, here we have a chamber above the spool. We have a chamber here. Okay, we are sending the pilot air here. Pilot air means the external auxiliary air, means external air that operates this slider is called pilot. Pilot air means the air which operates the valve is called pilot air. The air is coming at the top of the chamber. Okay, here the flow of pilot air is controlled with the help of a set screw. Okay, now the pilot air is entering into the port jet. The air is filling this chamber, okay, continuously. At the continuously, the air fills the chamber, the pressure of the air increases. At certain pressure, it pushes the spool towards down against spring. That opens the port P2A. Again, the pressure is more increases, then the port A and R are connected. Means the movement of this spool is depending on the pressure of the air at the chamber above the piston, above this slide. Okay, here the increase of pressure is depending on this port Z. So here we have a screw. Okay, we are setting the opening by with the help of this screw. So how much time to take the increase of pressure that required to move this spool is decided, right, with the help of this time set screw. Okay, if you time set screw, suppose if you delay is if you want to maintain the delay is less, if you open more, means if the chamber is filled fast and pressure developer is fast and that pressure pulls the spool. Suppose if you want to delay more, you need more delay. The screw is if you operate the screw, it closes the valve, means the opening closes. Means the air is slowly moving towards chamber. The filling of air is slow. That causes the pressure developing is slow. That required to move this spool. So, based on this screw position, okay, the air, the chamber is filled with air and pressure developed. The time taken for the developing of pressure that required to move the spool is changing. Okay, according to how much time is delayed to operate the valve is decided with the help of the pilot air. Suppose if you want to set after 5 minutes only the valve is opened, we are set the screw for the 5 minutes. After 5 minutes only the pressure required for the to move this spool is developed. So we are free setting the time to move this operate the valve. So automatically the valve is open, yet at what time we need to open that valve. So this is called time delay valve. Okay, this is the time delay diagram. This is the pilot air, this is the outlet port. There is a time delay between the, okay, because based on this time delay the outlet the valve is open or closed. Okay, we are setting that time, and this is the symbol for this time delay valve. Okay, this is the pilot valve. Z means port for the pilot air. The pilot air means which operates the valve, which moves the spool of the valve. Okay, here the spool of the valve is operated by air, not by manual. So this is the circuit. This circuit indicates the time delay circuit. This is the actual direction control valve. Okay, this valve is controlled with the help of the air from the port Z. That the air from the port Z is okay controlled with the help of a screw, that is time delay screw. Okay, this is about time delay valve. Okay, this is about valves. Okay, I will unmute you. If you have any doubts regarding three valves, you can ask me. Then I will go with another new topic. Hello, if you have any doubts, please ask me regarding three valves: exhaust valve, quick exhaust valve, and time delay valve and sequence valve. Please, if you don't have any doubts, so I will go with new topic. Please unmute yourself. Ask me if you have any doubts about three valves: quick exhaust, sequence, and time delay.
Hello.
Quick exhaust aimless, sir. Suppose if you want to remove the air suddenly. Okay. Hello, 47.
Chapman, sir.
ఇప్పుడు సిలిండర్ పిస్టన్స్ ఫాస్ట్ గా కిందకి వచ్చేయాలమ్మా. ఓకే, అంటే ఏంటి, లోపల సిలిండర్ లో ఉన్న ఎయిర్ తీసేయాలి. ఓకే, కానీ యాక్చువల్ గా డైరెక్షన్ కంట్రోల్ వాల్వ్ ద్వారా తీయాలనుకోండి, టైం పడుతుంది. అప్పుడు ఏం చేస్తాం, షార్ట్ కట్ లో తీసేస్తాం కదా. ఒక షార్ట్ కట్ వాల్వ్ మనం పెట్టాం అనుకోండి, అది రిమూవ్ చేయడమే టోటల్ గా టోటల్ ఎయిర్ అంతా ఒకేసారి బయటకు వెళ్ళిపోతుందాం. దాన్ని మనం ఏమంటాం అంటే క్విక్ ఎగ్జాస్ట్ వాల్వ్ అంటాం. హలో,
ఓకే సార్.
అంటే సడన్ గా మనం లోపల ఉన్న ఎయిర్ లాగేయాలంటే ఏదో ఒక షార్ట్ కట్ పెడతాం కదా, ఆ షార్ట్ కట్ ని మనం క్విక్ ఎగ్జాస్ట్ వాల్వ్. ఇంకేమైనా డౌట్స్? ఇప్పుడు కరెంట్ ఏదైనా తీసేయాలనుకోండి, ఏదైనా స్విచ్ ఆపరేట్ చేయడానికి టైం పడితే ఫ్యూజ్ లాగేస్తాం కదా. ఆ టైప్. ఓకే, నో డౌట్. ఓకే, ఐ విల్ గో విత్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్, నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్ ఈస్ యాక్చుయేటర్స్. Okay, one of the important component of the fluid system is actuators. Okay, what are the components of fluid system? I already told: pumps, valves, and last actuating components are actuators. Okay, actuator is nothing but the device which is used to perform the useful work, which produces the mechanical force. That device is called actuator. Actuator purpose is to produce the mechanical work. Okay, so generally the actuators are used for moving or gripping the objects by applying force. So actuators are the real devices in hydraulic circuits or fluid systems to apply the mechanical force. Okay, by using actuators we are doing some mechanical work, means we can move a part by using actuator, or we are hold the part by using actuators. So actuators are the main thing. Suppose our hands, human hands, these are the actuators. So we can hold it, we can do it, means actuation systems are the actuators are the devices which gives the mechanical force. So like our hands or legs. Okay, here we have different types of actuators: linear actuators and rotary actuators. Okay, linear actuators are two types: single acting cylinders, double acting cylinders. Rotary actuators are motors, air motors and rotary actuators. We have different types of rotary actuators. Now we see the different types of actuators used in fluid systems. Okay, first one, linear actuators. Linear actuators are two types: single acting cylinder and double acting cylinder. See this? This is a single acting cylinder. Okay, here we have a cylinder and piston assembly. One side of the piston is arranged with a spring. Here, spring loaded at one side of the piston. Now, the fluid is entering in one side of the piston. Suppose if you pump the fluid in this system, the piston moves towards right. Okay, sir, still admitting latecomers. Okay, means the fluid entering into this port, the piston moving towards right. Okay, and that is the extension of piston. Now the retract the piston means we have to reposition the piston, just remove the fluid from this chamber. Okay, then the piston comes to the leftward by with the help of spring, means spring causes the moving, restore the position of the piston, means we are supplying fluid in one side of the piston only. That's why it is called single acting cylinder. Okay, means the extension, the movement of the piston caused with the help of one side acting. We are sending fluid through one side of the piston only. It causes the movement of the piston towards right, and restoring of piston is done with the help of spring. Okay, this is called single acting cylinder actuator. Second one is double acting. See this. This is the piston. This is the air cylinder cross section. This is the piston. Okay. We have two sides. This is the air inlet and outlet. It acts as the inlet port and outlet port. Here we have inlet port and outlet port. Suppose if you send the air through this port, the piston is moving towards right. Okay. And this port removes the air from this chamber chamber which is at right side. Okay, suppose if you want to piston move towards left, we are sending air to this port and remove the air from the left chamber through this port, means same port act as inlet port and outlet port according to the movement of the piston. If you want to move the piston rightward, this is act as inlet port, this is act as outlet port. Suppose if you want to move the piston towards left, it is act as inlet port and it is act as outlet port, means we are sending air to the both sides of the piston. In previous case, we are sending air to one side of the piston only. But here we are sending air to both sides of piston. See this symbol. Means this side, if you want to move the piston rightwards, we are sending the air to left side and removing the air from right side. Suppose the piston is moving towards left, we are sending air to right side chamber and removing the air from the left side chamber. So both sides, we are applying the air. That's why it is called double acting cylinder. See this. This is the double acting cylinder. Means the air is moving, air is removing, air is coming and air is moving. Means both sides, there is an action of air is there. So this is called double acting cylinder. See this. This is single acting cylinder. Means extension of piston with the help of fluid. See this. means extension is because of fluid. Okay, retraction is because of spring. Okay, in retraction position, just we are removing the air from the chamber, and the spring causes the movement of the piston towards left. This is called single acting cylinder. Next one, and here we need to provide some cushion in double acting type actuator, because the rapid movement of the piston causes some impact, load and wear. So we need to provide some cushioning effect on both sides of the piston. See this is the cushioning flow here. These two are the cushioning sleeves, and means we are supplying some air here. Means this restricts the rapid movement of the piston. Means it causes some cushion. Means the piston moves fastly, that causes rapid force and wearing is problem is there. So we have to restrict the piston movement. Means we need to provide some cushion. For that purpose, we are providing some air opposite the movement of the piston. Okay, these two are the cushioning sleeves. We are supplying the air against the movement of the piston. So that reduces the rapid movement of the piston. That will avoid the damage of the piston and that avoids the wear. This is the cushioning of actuating cylinder. Next one, rotary type. Already those are linear type, single acting and double acting. Now we see the rotary type actuators. Rotary type actuators. See this. Here we are using rack and pinion mechanism. Means we need rotation. Means our actuator needs rotation. Okay. Means we need rotary motion rather than linear motion. Suppose this is the piston assembly. We are supplying air here. Suppose if you want to supply air in this way, the piston moves leftwards. That causes rotation of the pinion. This is the rack and pinion mechanism. The linear movement of the rack causes rotation of the pinion. So the linear movement of the rack causes the air. If you send air in this chamber, it moves leftwards. Suppose if you send air in this way, the piston moves rightward. Means the rack is moving rightwards and leftwards with the help of fluid. So the forward and the backward movement of the rack causes the rotation of the pinion. So here we are getting rotary motion with the help of rack. The rack movement is caused by fluid. So this is called rotary actuator. And next one, gear motor. Already I explained about gear pump. Okay, gear, this is the reverse to the gear pump. Here in pump, we are rotating the gear. Means we are sending fluid from inlet to outlet. But here, high pressure fluid is sending through this movement. Means this chamber, means high pressure. The fluid is coming from high pressure to low pressure. Means the kinetic velocity, kinetic energy of the fluid causes the rotation of the gears. Okay, it is reverse to the operation of the gear pump. There, rotation of gears causes movement of the fluid. Here, movement of fluid causes rotation of the gears. Means these gears are rotated with the help of the kinetic energy of the fluid. Means we are getting rotary motion through the kinetic energy of the fluid. Means fluid rotates the object. This is the called rotary actuator, gear motor. Here, vane motor. It is reversed to the vane pump. Already you know, the rotation of the vane pump causes the movement of the fluid from inlet to outlet. But here, the movement of the fluid causes rotation of the vane pump. Means we are sending high pressure fluid through vane that causes the rotation of the vanes. Means here we are connecting hydraulic energy, pressure energy into rotational energy. Means hydraulic energy into mechanical energy. So this is called vane motor. Here the fluid energy is converted into rotation. This is called rotary type actuator. So gear pump and vane motor are the actuator which gets rotation because of the energy of the fluid energy. Because of fluid, those are rotated. We need its rotation for doing mechanical work. These are the actuators. Okay. Next one is electro-pneumatics. Okay, I will unmute you. If you have any doubts regarding actuators, please ask me. Please unmute yourself. If you have any doubts regarding actuators, ask me. Actuators are the devices used for doing mechanical work. That work may be linear motion or rotary motion. So we have two types of actuators, linear actuators and rotary actuators. Those are operated by using fluids. Means either hydraulic energy or pneumatic energy is converted into mechanical energy for doing a particular task in mechatronic system. So please ask me if you have any doubts regarding actuators. Sir, any doubts? If you have any doubts, please unmute yourself and ask me. Okay, thank you. No doubts, I think. Okay, our next topic, electro-pneumatics. Electro-pneumatics. Up to now, we have seen the fluid systems, means both hydraulic systems and pneumatic systems and components used in hydraulic systems and pneumatic systems. Okay, now we see the combination, means now first we see the electro-pneumatics, means the combination of electrical and pneumatics, means the valves which are, the valves in the pneumatics are operated by using electrical, by means of electrical, then it is called electro-pneumatic systems. You know, we have different control valves in pneumatic systems. Those control valves are operated by means of electrical, then it is called electro-pneumatic systems. Means, suppose the direction control valve, suppose the direction control valve is opening and closing, or position changing of direction control valve is done with the help of electrical energy, then it is called electro-pneumatics. So electro-pneumatics means we are utilizing both electrical energy and pneumatic energy for operating the system. So then it is called electro-pneumatic systems. Means all pneumatic valves are operated by electrical energy, with the help of electrical energy. See this? We have four levels of components in electro-pneumatic systems. Okay, now what is the levels? The first level is energy supply. Just generally in pneumatic systems, only compressed air is required. But in electro-pneumatic system, we require both compressed air and pneumatic energy plus electrical energy. Either AC or DC power supply is required for operating valves. So energy supply it by with the help of both pneumatic and electrical energies are required for operating the electro-pneumatic system. Second one is input elements. Okay, here input elements are switches, because electrical and electrical equipment also there. So we need limiting switches and push buttons are related to pneumatics, and proximity sensors for finding the position of the piston. We need some sensors. So those are the input elements. Next, processing elements. So in processing elements, we have some logic elements are there, and solenoid valves are there. Solenoid actuated direction control valves are there, and electrical pneumatic electrical converters are there, relays are there. Okay, all these are processing elements, which are both are combination of pneumatic and electrical. And the last one is actuators. Here, you know, pneumatic cylinders and piston and cylinder combination is nothing but actuators. And we need motors, and we need solenoid operated direct control valves. So actuators also both combination of pneumatics and electrical. So we have these four levels for the electro-pneumatic systems: energy supply, input elements, processing elements, and actuating elements. The combination of the the combining of these four levels, so operating the electro-pneumatic system. Here we can supply both DC and AC, but the valves are operated by DC current. If you want to supply AC current, you need to convert the AC current to DC current by using rectifiers. Already you know the rectifiers. Okay, now we see the components of electro-pneumatic system. Now we see the components of electro-pneumatic system. So the first components are switches. Okay, so here we have three types of switches: NO switches, NC switches, and CO switches. NO means normally open switch, means the switch always open, normally open condition. Okay, see this. This is the NO switch. It is already open in position. If you want to actuate this, just close it. You see the actuated condition of the NO switch. Just it is normally open. If you want to operate this switch, just close the contact. This is called NO switch. Next one is NC switch. Normally closed means the switch is normally closed position. Initially that is closed position. For actuation, we just break up the contact between the switch. It is actuated condition. This is normally it is closed. Actuated means this is open. That is NC switch. Next one is CO switch, means change over switch. Means we are changing the contact. Initially the switch is contact with the left side terminal. This is the initial position. Okay, you can change over, means contact is here. We can break the contact and contact with the right side terminal. So we can change over the contact either left side or right side. This is called change over switch. These three types of switches are used in electro pneumatic circuits. Okay, what is NO switch, NC switch and change over switch. NO means initially it is opened. Actually, if you want to actuate it, just close the contact. Okay, NC switch means normally closed position. Okay, if you want to actuate, just open it, break it. Change over switch means just change the contact with the one side of the contact to other side. Okay, these are the three switches used in the electro pneumatic circuits. Relays. Next component which is used in the electro pneumatic circuits are relays. Okay, relay is a switch. See this. It connects the two circuits. Relay connects the two circuits. This is the initial circuit. This is the secondary circuit. This is the power source. This is the load. See this. Here we have a contact. You have two contacts. If you close this contact, okay, the power is moving towards output. So the closing of contact is done with the coil. Suppose I will explain the working. See this. First, we are supplying the power source. This is the control switch. If you close this switch, the power is supplied to this coil. Okay, the coil is activated. Means the current is flowing around the coil. This already you know self inductance. Okay, if there is a magnetic core around a coil is wound around the magnetic core. If you supply a current through coil, it energizes the magnet, means the magnet flux is induced in the magnetic core. Means this core is act as magnet. If you supply the power, this core is act as magnet. So if you close the control switch, it allows the flow through current to this coil, then this core converted into magnet. That magnet attracts this stem. The magnet attracts this stem, means it attracts means it closes. Okay, this is moving towards this contact. These two are closed with the help of this core. Big magnetism pulls this towards close. This means the contact between these two terminals will be happened because of magnetic force caused by this core. Then current is flowing to load. This type of operation is called relay. This is called relay. So relay consists of a coil. Okay, the closing and opening of switch causes by this magnetic core. So this magnetic core is operated with the help of control switch. Okay, if you off this, open this close control switch, current flowing is reduced and magnetism is disappear and is the stem moving away from the magnet. So this magnet pulls and pushes the opens and closes this switch. This is called relay. So this is the symbol of the relay. K1 means coil. Okay, opening and closing of the switch is due to the coil. Okay, if you supply the current, it acts as a magnet. Okay, magnetism closes this switch. Okay, if you supply is cut off the supply and there is no magnetism, automatically the switch is opened. So closing and opening of switch is done with the help of electromagnetism. This is called relay. Okay, here we have logic blocks. Okay, logic blocks means we have three different types of logic blocks. First, unblock, odd block, and not block. See this. In unblock, the switches are connected in series. S1, S2 are the switches. Okay, those are connected in series. Means the current is flowing from this end to this end. Okay, only when the two switches are closed. Means both S1 and S2 are closed, then only output signal is produced. Otherwise, there is no flow of current. So logic, this is called unlogic. So if you want to produce output, we need to close the both switches. Next, R block means these are connected in parallel. Means if you want to supply current from this end to this end, either S1 or S2 are closed, you can supply the power from this end to this end. If you close the S1, the current is flowing through in this direction. Okay, if you close the S2, the current is flow in this direction. Means the operating of S1 or S2, either one switch is enough to produce the output. This logic is called R function. Next one is NOT function. Then next one is NOT function. Means there is no flow of current. Initially, the switch is not actuated. The signal is, means output is there. Already it is in closed condition. So there is output is there. Okay. If switch removes, there is no flow of current. Initially, there is output is generated. Okay, means not actuated. The system is not actuated. The output is generated because already in closed condition. If actuation means just break down the switch, that is actuation. Means no current is flowing through this circuit. Means not. Okay, initially it is in off position, means there is a flow of supply. On position means we are cut off this supply. That is not block. These are three are the logic blocks. And we have one more block, that is memory block. This is memory block. The main purpose of the memory block is to use it to hold the solenoid valves. Means suppose if the valve is opening or closed, means suppose the valve is opening. So we need to open that valve up to certain period, means 5 minutes or 2 minutes. We need to open, keep the valve in open position. For that purpose, we are using memory blocks. Means, suppose if you want to open the valve for 2 minutes, means you need to keep the valve position in open for 2 minutes. For that periods, means we need to keep the valve open in 2 minutes. We are using memory blocks. See this. In the memory block circuit, here we are using relay and switches. Okay, here S1 and S2 switches are there, and K1 is the relay. Okay, if S1 is operated, if you S1 is closed, okay, this activates the K1, means coil. Already I told, means magnet is excited and the magnetism closes the valve. Means it K1 closes the switch, means the flow of current is possible. Okay, even if you remove this one, still it K1 is acting because of S2. Already S2 is in closed position. S2 is the NC valve. So S2 is already closed position. So the flow of current is moving through S2 to K1 up to certain period. Okay. First, the opening and closing of the K1 valve is done with the S1. But off the K1, we need to apply the S2 only. Okay? See this. Once again, I will explain. If you want to close this switch, if K1 is operated by S1. If you close the S1, okay, the circuit operates the K1, the K1 switch is closed. Okay? Now the flow of current is moving from this in this direction. Okay, even if you open the S1, still the flow of current is moving through K1. Okay, because of S2. Okay, if you want to cut off the flow, just open the S2. Means up to what period you want to hold the valve open. Okay, we are keeping the S2 in on. Then only if you want to stop the valve, just off this S2 valve, you can break the K1. Okay. And we have one more circuit for memory circuit. See here. Okay. Here S2 and S1 are connected in series. S1 and S2 are connected in series. Here S2 is the domination. Okay. Even if we suppose S2 is open, even if you on the S1 and S1 causes operation of K1, still there is no current because S2 and S1 is in series. So when S2 is in closed on position, then only S1 and K1 are operated. Means there is a possibility for S1. So here dominated factor is S2. Okay, by arranging these S1, S2 and K1 relays, we can hold the valve open position up to certain period. These are called memory blocks. Okay, here dominant is S2. In previous case, you can individually operate S1 and S2 because S1 and S2 are in parallel position. Okay, you can operate the S1 without permission of S2 because these two are parallel. Okay, S1, if you close the S1, K1 is operated because this is a relay. Already I explained about the relay. Okay, but in case, next case, both are in series. Here S2 is the main factor. So by using the operation of S1 and S2, we keep the valve. We can extend the period of the opening or closing of the valve. Okay, these are called memory blocks. Next one is solenoid valve. Okay, I will stop with this valve. I will explain the working of solenoid valve. Solenoid valve. See this? Solenoid means a coil which is wound around the magnetic core is nothing but solenoid. Okay, see this? This is the solenoid valve. Okay, here there is a magnetic core in between and a coil is wound around this core. See this? This is the magnetic core and a coil is wound around this magnetic core. Switch. Okay, if you close this switch, current is flowing through this coil. Okay, you know, if there is flowing current through this coil, that activates the armature. Okay, you know, electrical generator motor principle. Okay, whenever if you keep a magnetic core, an armature, okay, between the magnetic flux, some force is exerted on that part. You know, the principle of generator and a motor. Okay, whenever generator means whenever conductor cuts the magnetic flux, an EMF is induced. Okay, but in case of motor, if you keep the conductor in between the magnetic flux, a force is exerted on the conductor. So here, we are keeping an armature here. This is the armature, not core. This is the armature. Okay, here we have a some magnetic, okay, it is a solenoid, means there is a coil around this. If you supply the current, okay, that causes the movement of the core. That causes the movement of the core, means it is an open position. Now it is closing, means it activates the coil and this causes the movement of the core between the coil, means the core is moving. The core, so the valve opening and closing is attached to this core, means this slider, this is connected to slider that opens the, closes the ports. Okay, there is a spring. Suppose if you off the switch, okay, the spring pulls the core to its original position. Okay, means the operation, switching on or off, or causes the linear movement of the core. That moves the sliding of the spool that causes the opening and closes of the ports. This is the operation of solenoid valve. Okay, now once again, I will explain. This is the armature. In between, there is the armature is there. Okay, if you initially, there is no contact, there is no power supply to this solenoid coil. Okay, this is the coil around this armature. Okay, it is attached with spring. Initially no current, means there is no movement in the armature. Then you switch off the, switch on this, means you contact this, it causes flow of current, means the current is flowing around the coil that causes movement of the core in linear direction. So So the core is moving outwards. Okay, and switch off. Contact is released. Okay, there is no electrical current in the coil. Okay, that's why the spring which is attached to the core is pulls the this core to back position. Okay, so here the current causes the linear movement of the core. This linear movement of core is attached to the wall. Okay, the movement of this spool means slider is caused by this wall. So that slider opens the ports, present port, A port and B port and return port. So the movement of the closing and opening of the port is done with the help of the movement of the armature in the solenoid. This is called solenoid valve. So if you have any doubts, please ask me, unmute yourself.